Hello, my dear friends, my dear students. Now we are going to discuss interior and exterior routing protocols. In the previous lectures, we have discussed introduction to router and configuration of router. In the present lecture, we are going to discuss one by one interior and exterior routing protocols. So first of all, take on interior routing protocols. So interior routing protocols are nothing but these are the routing protocols which are used by the various routers, various computational units to transfer the messages, transfer the packets from one local area network to another local area network or within the local area network. Okay. While on the other hand, exterior routing protocols are the protocols which are used by these intelligent devices, so called routers or autonomous systems, okay, for receiving and sending these messages between these autonomous systems. Okay, so this is a basic difference between interior and exterior routing protocols. So in other words, you can say interior routing protocols are designed to be using inside autonomous systems, that is inside routers, while exterior routing protocols are designed to be used between autonomous systems, between two routers, okay, or more routers. So IGP, that is interior gateway protocol, is a routing protocol that was designed and intended for use inside a single autonomous system. Okay, if there is a one router which is handling the traffic from various computational units, then there comes interior routing protocol. Okay, there comes in picture interior routing protocol. While on the other hand, what is EGP? EGP is nothing but it is exterior gateway protocol or a routing protocol that was designed and intended for use between different autonomous systems, that is different routers. If there are two routers communicating to each other, okay, sharing the information with each other, or more than one router there are, then exterior routing protocols comes in picture. Okay. So for sake of information, you should always remember that there is only one EGP or BGP, that is Water Gateway Protocol, but there are many internal or interior gateway protocols. So now we are going to define interior gateway routing protocols. So interior gateway routing protocols are nothing but these are proprietary distance vector routing protocols. Okay, they use the two parameter, one is the distance and another one is the vector. Okay, so distance is nothing but it is the hop counts. Okay, so IGRP manages the flow of routing information between connected routers. So with the help of IGRP, that is interior gateway routing protocols, we are going to manage the flow of routing information, that is for that particular destination, how many paths are there for that particular destination, okay, which path is better to deliver the packets. Okay, so such type of information is transmitted between these autonomous systems. Okay, the protocol ensures that every router has routing table updated within the best available path. Or this interior gateway routing protocol also responsible for the updation of routing information between these routers. Okay, this ensures that as early as possible the routers have the fresh information. So they refreshes these routers. So this interior gateway routing protocol has the responsibility to refresh these routers as early as possible. IGRP also avoids routing loops by updating itself. This also avoids the formation of loops within the network, okay, so that the packet reaches its destination in a very little time. Okay, now we are going to take on another topic. So to explain the interior gateway routing protocol, the following points becomes handy. The following points are handy to explain the interior gateway routing protocol. So the creator of interior gateway routing protocol is Cisco. So Cisco created interior gateway routing protocol in response to the limitations in routing information protocol, that is RIP. So initially RIP is the only protocol which is used for the information exchange within the routers, between the routers. Okay, but this routing information protocol, that is RIP, has some limitations. To overcome these limitations, Cisco devised a novice algorithm that is known as the Interior Gateway Routing Protocol. Okay, so this protocol handles 255 maximum hop counts, while on the other hand, routing information protocol handles a maximum hop count of 15. So Interior Gateway Routing Protocols handles 15 into 15, that is more than 15 times than the RIP. Okay, so this Interior Gateway Routing Protocols handles a maximum hop count of 255, which is more than 15 times of routing information protocol, which handles only 15 hop counts. The primary two purpose of IGRP are to make the routers communicate routing information to all connected routers within its boundary, and to continually updating whenever there is a topological network or path change that occurs. It means whenever there is a local area network which follows the ring topology or in a path, we come across with a network which follows the bus topology. In a further path, we come across with a network which has the star topology. Then this information is instantly updated and transmitted to all of the routers between the area. IGRP sends a notification of any new change or information about its states to its neighbor routers in every 90 seconds. So in every 1.5 minutes, each router is going to be refreshed due to this IGRP, Interior Gateway Routing Protocol. This IGRP manages a routing table with the most optimal path to respective nodes. So each router has a table which has most optimal path between these routers. And now this information is shared between this parent network. Because it is a distance vector protocol, IGRP uses several parameters to calculate the metric for the best path to a specific destination. Okay, so the parameters includes number one, delay and bandwidth, then reliability, load and maximum transfer unit. So first of all, what's about the delay? So delay is the parameter, okay, which focuses that the particular packet has its destination in how many times. Initially it is calculated that it should be at its destination in 15 hops, but it takes 20 hops, so it has a delay of 5 hops. Okay, next come to the bandwidth. So bandwidth is nothing but it is the actual capacity of that network. Initially there is a capacity of this kbps, but after it becomes only a little amount of this bandwidth, or it increases the bandwidth. Okay, next one is the reliability. How reliable is the network? There is a network which consisting of, suppose they, which consisting of 5 routers. So it may be that in a certain span of time 2 routers become in the sleepy mode, then this network is not a reliable network. Okay, next is the load. How much load is going to be transferred between these routers? Okay, what is the traffic? And next is the maximum transmission unit. So maximum transmission unit, MTU, defines how many packet length is transmitted with a single packet. Okay, so now we are going to take on the types of routing protocols. So the following literature showed how routing protocols can be classified according to various characteristics. Okay, this section gives an overview of the most common IP routing protocols. Most of these routing protocols will be examined in detail in further interactions between you and us. Okay. For now, this section gives a very brief overview of each protocol. Okay. Now take on classifying routing protocol in the next lecture. Okay. So, for this duration, just see the notes provided by me and other material whatsoever you have. Okay. And we in the homes, okay, keep your safety, we in the homes, and support, avoid corona perspective. Thank you.